Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you the concept of binary search tree. Till now, I have covered the introduction, representation and the operations that can be performed on a binary search tree. Then I have explained how to create the binary search tree and how to insert a node by following the rules of the binary search tree. Then we have studied the search operation on a binary search tree, and now it's time to learn the delete operation that can be performed on a binary search tree. The next video of this video series will be how to perform display operation on a binary search tree. So to learn all the details about binary search tree, I would like to request you to stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Let's start with the concept of binary search tree. So binary search tree is a special kind of binary tree which exhibits a special characteristic or a behavior. That characteristic is nothing but all the nodes which are present in a left subtree are having a value is less than that of the root node, and all the nodes which are present in a right subtree are having a value which is greater than a root node. For your reference, I am providing you a binary search tree here with which you can understand the concept of binary search tree. These different operations that can be performed on a binary search tree, from which we are going to focus on the delete operation in this video. So let's start with the delete operation on a binary search tree. The delete operation. What is the significance of this delete operation? So whenever you want to perform the delete operation for any particular key onto a constructed binary tree, then this function, this operation will help you to delete the key value. For that, very first thing is you supposed to search the delete key starting from a root node, and once you find the delete key, then we supposed to consider three different cases while performing the delete operation. And if the delete key doesn't found, then there is no any meaning to perform delete operation onto the binary search tree. So let's see which three different cases we supposed to handle while performing the delete operation. This is the first case where if we want to delete a leaf node. The second case, if a node which we want to delete has a single child only. And the case number 3, if the node which we want to delete is having both the child nodes. So with these three different cases, we'll start with the first solved example. Now let's focus only on the case number 1. So let's see what the steps we supposed to follow if we want to delete a leaf node. This is the constructed binary search tree is with us, and if I want to delete a leaf node, then what the steps I have to follow. Let's accept a key value from a user. Here you can see that the key 25 is a leaf node. So what the steps we supposed to follow if we want to delete any of the leaf node from the binary search tree. The first step is we are going to start the searching of the key which we want to delete, and that will start from the root node. So let's start with a root node, compare it with a root node. The key value is less than a root node, so that's why let's check for its left subtree whether it is present or not. Yes, it is present. Make this left child as a root node and compare once again. After comparison, you will come to know that key value 22 is less than current root node. Let's check for its left child. As it is present, step down to this left child and make this 19 as a current root node. Again, compare the key value 22 with the current root node 19. as 22 key value is greater than 19. So let's check for its right child. As right child is present, step down to the right child and make it as a current root node. Let's compare the key value 22 with the current root node 22. Both are equal, and here you can say that the key value is found in the constructed binary search tree. This is only the searching part for the deletion of the node. If the key is present, then and then only we can perform the delete operation. And as key is found, now let's go forward for the next step to perform delete operation onto the leaf node. So here the next step is to delete a key node. So we'll directly delete a key node, and we supposed to update the right child field or a right pointer of this node, parent node 19, that will become null to indicate that no any right child is present to the parent node 19. So in this way we can perform the delete operation of a leaf node. Now let's move forward for the second case, where if I want to delete any of the key, that key if is having a single child node, then what we have to do. So let's go through the same example. Let's accept a key value. It is 86. So very first step is to perform search operation to search the delete key, and for that we have to start from a root node. Let's compare a root node 56 with 86. As 86 key value is greater than the root node 56, then let's check for the right child for a root node. As it is present, step down to the right child and make this as a root node. So 65, we are making it as a root node, and let's compare key value with the current root node at 65. As key value 86 is greater than the current root node 65, check for its right child. As right child is present, step down to its right child and make 86 as a current root node. Compare both the value. As both are equal, here we can take a decision that the delete key is found into the constructed binary tree, and hence go forward for the steps that we supposed to perform for the delete operation on the node with a single child. Here you can observe, if I want to delete this node 86, I should have to take care of its child node. If this node is deleted, then we can't keep this 72 as dangling. We have to take care of this left child of a parent node 86. So for that, first of all, delete the key node. And here, what we have to do, we have to copy the child node, and that we have to paste it as a right child of the node's parent node, or key, or the key values parent node. The key values parent node was 65, and we have to attach it as the right child, as 86 was the right child of the parent node 65. So in short, we will replace the delete key value with its either child node. If it is a left child, paste it as a at the position of the parent node or the node 86, and if it was a right child, in the same case also we will perform the same operation. Let's move forward for the next and the third case, where if the node which we want to delete is having both the child nodes. As we have seen just now, if a single node is there, in that case what we have to do, for a single child we will replace the child node at the position of the delete key, and we have done with the delete operation. But now if the node which we want to delete is having both the children, then we have to consider two different ways. The first way is, we will think about the in order successor, and that in order successor we will replace with the to be deleted node. And the second way is, instead of in order successor, we will go forward for the in order predecessor. and that in order predecessor we will replace with the to be deleted node. I am going to explain you both the cases with the solved example. So let's consider the first way, first of all, where we will go forward for the in order successor. So here I am explaining you the deletion operation on the node with which is having both the child nodes. So if the in order successor is there, we are going to find out the in order successor and then we will perform the delete operation on the to be deleted key. So let's accept the key value, it is 25. Here you can observe for the node 25 is having both the child node, that is left child is 19 and right child is 36. So what we have to do, first of all let's go for a searching for the key value right from a root node. So let's start with the root node. As 25 is less than 56, let's check for the left child of the 56. As it is present, move to the left child and make it as a root node. So 25 is current root node. Compare both the values, as both are equal, here we can take a decision that the key value is found. Delete key value is found. As delete key value is having both the child nodes, its left child is 19, right child is 16, as we are forwarding with the way in order successor, let's find out the in order successor of the node or a key value. So which one is the in order successor in this case? In order successor is 36. All of you are knowing the concept of in order traversal of the binary tree. You supposed to apply the in order traversal and you supposed to find out the in order successor of the current to be deleted node. It's 36. And now what the next step we have to do? We have to copy the content of in order successor to the to be deleted node. So let's copy it. Here you can see I have copied the content of the in order successor or the node itself, and then we are going to delete the in order successor. So in this way we can delete the node which is having both the child nodes. So 25 is replaced with the in order successor and we have done with our task. Now let's move forward for the another way. If I want to delete a node with the both child, then the second way is to replace the to be deleted node with in order predecessor. So let's move forward for the case in order predecessor. Here you can see that the same example I am moving forward. Let's accept the key value, it is 56. Start searching for a node and it is present at the root node position itself. Now our next step is to find out the in order predecessor, as we are considering the way with which we are going to delete a node which is having both children. 56 is having its left child as well as a right child. So if this is the situation, then we can find out the in order predecessor. So let's find out the in order predecessor. Here we have done with the searching of in order predecessor and it is 36. Now let's copy the content of in order predecessor to the to be deleted node. I'm very sorry, it should be in order predecessor. Let's copy it, and after copying you can see over here 56 is replaced with 36, and you can remove this node. Then after deletion your tree will look like this. 19 is going to become a left child. It was just same as of the previous case, only the right child field we supposed to update with the address of node 65. So in this way we can perform the delete operation onto the nodes on a binary search tree. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the video and the content, please do not forget to give the comment and do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks, along with the next video of this video series and a whole playlist also I am providing here for your reference. Thank you. happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.